Various organizations assert the urgent need to audit the debts of the Philippine government. Jackie Pascual is on the line with the details. Jackie?
Good afternoon, Denise. Civil society groups have launched a citizens' debt audit to review the debts and loans incurred by the Philippine government in the past years. At a media briefing in Quezon City, various groups said there is a need to scrutinize the many loans the government got, as some of these loans may have unfair provisions or may have had negative effects to a specific project. They said government must stop or suspend paying these questionable loans. Lee D. Nakpil, coordinator for Asian People's Movement on Debt and Development, said if indeed some loans are dubious or not beneficial to Filipinos, there is a global precedent on debt cancellation, debt relief efforts, or debt service moratorium. The latter would give time for the government to strengthen a case against the lender if in case the loan was proven to be questionable or has a negative effect on the community, the environment, and the economy. The groups now plan to review select loans or debt projects. Among the possible projects are the loans incurred for the country's COVID-19 response, the Kaliwa Dam project, and those that fund fossil fuel projects.
Ang mga gobyerno naman, dapat piliin ano ba yung dapat patuloy na bayaran at yung mga hindi naman makatarong ang utang, huwag na bayaran. So ang tinatawag dyan ay debt repudiation.
We have to pursue a self-reliant, independent program of economic development. Para bang naging normal ang pangungutang sa gobyerno ngayon. Pag may kulang, may infrastructure, sino kaya magpapautang? Para reflex, automatic, parang default.
The groups hope that government too would begin its own debt audit to help the country. The Bureau of Treasury has reported that the country's national debt is 13.42 trillion pesos as of the end of 2022. The debt-to-GDP ratio is at 60.9%. And that's the latest. Back to you, Denise.
Thanks, Jackie. Here at home, the Philippine Justice Department lowers the bail amount for indigents who are facing criminal charges. In a new circular issued Monday, the bail amount is now set to a maximum of 10,000 pesos. Indigents could prove their eligibility by presenting their latest income tax return, any proof of income, or a certificate of indigency. Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla says some detainees cannot afford to post bail. He adds this is part of the government's efforts to decongest the country's jail facilities.
Tingnan natin ang laman ng ating mga piitan, ng ating mga kulungan. Marami kasi dito talaga ay kulang lang talaga sa pantustos, no? At kaya nga lahat ito ginagawa natin upang maayos natin ang sistema ng justisya, yung mga piitan na punong-puno, 300% to 1,000% full, eh sana naman mabawasan natin ang laman. At ito ay pinag-aaralan ng gusto ng kagawaran ng justisya at ng Korte Suprema kung paano namin paggagangin para gumaang naman ang kargo ng bayan. Kasi nga, napakahirap naman na ang tao ay siksikan sa kulungan.
Philippine prison officials welcome the Justice Department's order reducing the bail amount for indigents, saying this will help decongest jails. Zian Ambrosio joins us on the line with the details. Zian?
Bureau of Elections 11 ordered by the Department of Justice, where it lessens the fine for the complaint filed against suspects at the prosecution. According to BJMP spokesperson Jail Chief Inspector J. Rex Bustinev, the BJMP believes that this is one of the solutions to congested cells in detention nationwide. As of today, it has already 360% in terms of congestion. The BJMP believes that people who will benefit from this new circular will be the people who will be arrested by the police, especially those who can prove that they are indigent. Bustinera further explained the case of illegal gambling such as the Cara Cruz. The fine used to be worth 30,000 pesos, but with the new order, it will only be 10,000 pesos or less, depending on the prosecutor. Bustinera clarified that it will not be retroactive or effective for those who are already in the detention centers. This will be only effective with the new criminal cases. It is also not effective with a life sentence.
Zian Ambrosio with that report. Thanks. Now, for her reaction